Now we will discuss the next important topic of diode circuits, that is zener voltage regulator. This is the last topic of diode circuits and a very important topic. This is the zener voltage regulator, where the zener diode is connected across the load. We know the voltage of across the zener diode under reverse bias mode is always almost fixed at a level of VZ. So, we will assume that zener diode is the supply voltage is sufficient enough that zener is working in breakdown mode. When zener works in breakdown mode, you can see the characteristic of zener. So, voltage across the diode is fixed, but current through the diode can vary. Fine. But current has got certain limitation. Number one, the minimum current through the diode is IZ ni, that is the minimum current, IZ ni current, that is IZ ni. This is the minimum current through the zener diode. Current should not fall below ni current because its voltage regulation will become poor. So, VZ will not remain constant. If you can see, the voltage VZ will not remain constant if current falls below ni current, right? Resistance of the diode will vary. Then, maximum current through the zener diode depends upon the maximum power dissipation capability of the diode. We know if maximum power dissipation capability of the diode is given to you, that must be equal to IZ max square into RZ, where RZ is the resistance of zener diode under reverse bias mode. So, IZ max will be equal to PD max, that is maximum power dissipation capability, by RZ under root, where RZ is resistance of zener diode, resistance of zener diode in breakdown region when it is working in breakdown zone, and zener is always designed for breakdown zone so that its power is dissipated to the surrounding. Fine. So, circuit always works in breakdown region, but remember, minimum current through the zener diode should not fall below IZ ni and maximum current should not cross IZ max. If nothing is given, then I will say there is no limit of IZ max, any current can flow through it. If IZ ni is not given, that means current can reduce to zero. That will be our assumption if IZ ni and IZ max are not given to us. Fine. So, now let us see how to design the circuit. Here in this circuit, there are three possibilities. What are the possibilities? Load is variable, resistance is variable, voltage is variable. So, this can be variable, this can be variable, this can be variable. All three can be variable together. Two resistances can be variable together, load and supply voltage can be variable together, and so on. There are multiple possible combinations. But here in the theoretical analysis becomes complex if you take all the elements variable together. So, in this analysis, in this circuit, while discussing with you all, I will be taking only one parameter as variable at a time. Maybe RL as a variable, maybe RS as a variable, maybe VS as variable. K, one by one, I will be taking three cases, when supply voltage is variable, when RS is variable, when RL is variable. We will see what will be the limitations on the different parameters. Now, case 1. I will be taking different cases, case 1. Case 1 is what? When RL is variable. When RL is variable, so this will not be variable. So, I will say this is not variable. Now, please remember, what is the purpose of the analysis? Purpose of the analysis is to design the circuit. If load resistance is variable, you may have to find RS and VS. Fine. So, that will be and range of you can say range of the load current RS and VS. So this is what you need to find. Now, when RL is variable, remember voltage across the zener is fixed, that is Vzend. So what will be load current? Load current IL. Load current, you know, load current, that is IL, is equal to, that is Vz by RL, right? But this is, if RL is variable, if RL is variable, then definitely IL is variable. So IL minimum will be equal to what? IL minimum will be Vz RL maximum, and IL maximum will be how much? IL maximum will be Vz by RL minimum. That's what you have. Fine. So please see the circuit. Vz is fixed, Vs is fixed, RS is fixed, so Is will be fixed. So Is is equal to what? Supply voltage minus zener voltage by source resistance RS. Vz is fixed voltage, Vs supply voltage is fixed, RS is fixed, so Is is fixed. So this is fixed. Now, what will be Iz max? Iz max, according to this, is, or you can say, you can please see, Iz is equal to what? Is minus IL. So zener current Iz is what? Source current minus load current. That is source current minus load current. Source current is fixed. Why? Because Vs is fixed, Vz is fixed, Rs is fixed. So source current is fixed. So if IL is variable, so when IL is minimum, Iz will be maximum. So Iz maximum will be how much? Iz maximum will be equal to, that is Is minus IL minimum. And what will be Iz minimum? Iz minimum will be equal to Is minus IL maximum. Fine. And you have to see the limiting value of Iz max. Although this is giving you Iz max, but you know how to define this limits the Iz max, this limits Iz ne. But that is how we can design the circuit. Fine. By using different equations. I am just giving you the analysis, the approach, that when your load resistance is variable, I have the two different currents, load currents, I have single source current, but two different zener current, right? Let us take case 2. In case 2, let us take RS as variable. When RS is variable, let us see what could be the possibility. When RS is variable, I will say RL is fixed. This is variable now. I will be taking three cases, I told, one by one. First, I have taken RL is variable, these two are fixed. Second, I will be taking RS is variable, these two are fixed. I repeat, these are not standard analysis, these are the approaches to solve the questions, how the questions are framed. You should be knowing, remember, out of these three, you may have any of the variables. Fine. And accordingly, you may have to find the range of load resistance, range of source resistance, and range of your source voltage. When RS is variable, please see RL is fixed. So what is IL? IL will be equal to that is nothing but, that is Vz by RL. Fine. Right? So now, this gives IL is equal to what? Vz upon RL. So IL is what? Fixed. Now, what is Is? Is equal to, that is Vs minus Vz by Rs. So what is Rs? That is Vs minus Vz by Is, right? Now, what is Is minimum? Is minimum will be equal to IL minus Iz maximum, IL plus Iz minimum. Please see, what is this current? If you apply KCL here, this plus this, so what will be minimum source current? Minimum source current will be equal to load current is fixed, so minimum Z current, so that is what? Iz ni, so this is Iz ni, so this gives minimum current. And what is Is maximum? That is IL plus Iz max, right? So this gives, now please see it carefully, I have got minimum value, so what will be Rs max? That is equal to Vs minus Vz by Is minimum. When source current is minimum, the source resistance will be maximum, and this is equal to Vs minus Vz. And what is Is minimum? That is this, so that is IL plus Iz ni, that is equal to, that is your Iz ni. Similarly, what will be Rs minimum? That is Vs minus Vz by IL plus Iz max. When this current is maximum, so this is maximum, this will be minimum. So this, you can find the minimum and maximum value of source resistance. I forgot to mention one thing. Here I have obtained the limit of what? Iz. If I take it other way round, let us see what will be minimum and maximum source current. So this is, I will modify this equation. Suppose you want to find the range of RL. So what is RL? That is nothing but Vz upon IL. I want to find the range of RL, just like range of source resistance, because that is the design parameter. So this is nothing but IL is what? See it from here. What is IL? IL is nothing but Is minus Iz. IL is what? This minus this current is IL. You can simply apply KCL here. So this is what? Is minus, this is IL. So this gives Vz upon Is minus Iz. So when this is minimum, this will be maximum, this will be minimum. So what will be RL minimum? RL minimum will be Vz upon Is minus Iz ni, because the current cannot fall below this. Similarly, what will be RL maximum? That is Vz by Is minus Iz max. How are we getting this? Because source current is fixed in this case. Case 1, source current is fixed to this level. So by finding the minimum value of Iz Iz here, I can find minimum and maximum value of RL. When Iz is smallest, that is ni value, RL is minimum. When Iz is maximum, that is determined by power dissipation, you will get RL maximum. I mean to say, you may have to find these design, these are the design parameters, fine. So that is how we do. Similarly, let us take case 3. In case 3, let us take the variable voltage source. So you have to find the range of that voltage source for this particular circuit. So RS is, whichever is variable, you have to design the range of that variable. So case 3, I am saying Vs is variable, and if Vs is variable, you have to find its safe limits. So now let us see, if this is variable, this is fixed, so what is IL? IL will be fixed, that is what? Vz upon RL. What will be Is? Is is nothing but Iz plus IL. IL is fixed, so what will be Is minimum? Is minimum will be Izd plus IL. And what will be Is maximum? That will be equal to Iz max plus IL. So what will be Vs minimum? Minimum supply voltage, Vs minimum, will be equal to, you can please see, that is what? Is Rs plus VZ, and IS, this is what, I'll rewrite it like this, IS minimum plus RS plus VZ. Why? Because when IS, this is variable, the only variable is this, RS is fixed here. So if this is fixed, this is fixed, so this is variable, when this is minimum, this will be minimum, when this is maximum, this will be maximum. So this gives the range of source voltage for the safe limits. VS max is equal to IS max RS plus VZ. And how we determine IS minimum and IS max? From these equations. So these two equations are giving me the range of supply voltage for the safe operation of the circuit. That is how we define. So whichever is variable, that may have to be calculated from the given parameters. What will be given to you? Knee current. If it is not given, take it zero. Then you may be given power, maximum power dissipation. If that is not given, take any value of the current, fine. Or you may have to find the maximum power dissipation. So maximum power dissipation, how to find the maximum value of the current through the diode, square into square of that current into resistance will be maximum power dissipation in the diode, and diode should be able to dissipate that much power. So that will be called as minimum power to be dissipated by the diode. So these are the different types of questions from Zener diode. This is a really important topic, but this is the analysis I have given you. Sir, questions will be framed in different manners. So the concept really will be clear after you handle the solve the different questions on Zener voltage regulator. I'll be solving you the questions for you separately, but for the time being, just remember how to take the different cases, how to design load resistance, how to design the source resistance, how to design the source voltage under different circumstances given to you for the different parameters. So just wait for my next video to come. I'll be solving the numericals on Zener voltage regulator, and that finishes the diode circuits whole chapter, complete chapter, for engineering services, for GATE, for civil services, for ISRO, and for different competitive exams. This will be enough for you to qualify the exam or to handle the questions from diode circuits. So thank you very much for watching the video. Wait for my next video.